Hello and welcome. Now I will take a look with you at how the growth of cities affects the use of natural resources. As our world becomes more and more urban, there's evidence that the resource use efficiency goes up. Density is a good explanatory variable for this. Take the example of heating of buildings. As density goes up, the heating demand goes down. This can be explained by the fact that the walls are shared and the relationship between the volume of the building and the outer surface area decreases, such as here for the case of flats in multi-story buildings. This picture shows a simplification of this multi-story building. You can see that many cubes or flats of the same kind together result in a reduction of the surface-to-volume ratio. So while the first cube, the surface area was 6 times larger than the volume, it is now, when using 3 cubes up and 3 cubes down and sideways, only 2 times larger. Applying this to the urban area means that houses should, for instance, have at least 3 levels or more to make use of this effect, as can be seen in the rapidly declining green line. Everything below is really heating and cooling inefficient, as temperature changes are rapid and therefore use more energy for heating and cooling. A similar relationship has been suggested for transport, which is more efficient in dense cities, because distances are shorter and alternative modes of transport can be used. This can be seen here in the example of New York City and the fact that the red line, density, is declining to the outer suburbs, and the energy used per capita goes up. Other infrastructures can also be built much more efficient in cities rather than in the rural surroundings. For instance, the costs and the material used for sewers and water pipes reduces as density, here measured as floor space index, increases, as well as the construction material per floor area, as shown here. Similarly, district heating networks, so networks where, for instance, waste heat from centralized incineration is supplied to households, is much more effective in urban areas, as there is heat loss from long transport distances. Furthermore, some people propose that reuse and cascading of resources is easily implemented in urban areas, as the supply and demand of large quantities of waste resources is in close proximity. But it is not all that positive. Cities cause also more natural resource use, for instance, by trapping heat and being hotter than the surrounding landscape, which causes more energy use, for instance, for cooling. Or large cities require large transport distances for food or other products. Yet, some studies also show that a more rural and suburban lifestyle can improve the self-sufficiency and self-reliance. Freestanding family homes have, for instance, a much higher area of roof space for PV generation per inhabitant than large high-rises. This property can help make them nearly energy neutral, as here in Freiburg, Germany. The relationship between density and energy use is summarized neatly in this figure. It shows that higher density living uses less energy for transport and buildings. It also shows that the production of solar energy is lower in dense areas. Furthermore, historically, human waste has been transported away from the city to the agricultural areas. As a result, the treatment and direct reuse of nutrients and water contained in feces is currently, if at all, much more frequently practiced in more rural settings where points of supply and demand are close together. In this context, it is of course also clear that single homes with gardens have much more opportunities to supply a larger share of their food from their own ground, making urban dwellers more reliant and therefore vulnerable to food supply shortages. So while our world is getting more and more urban, our resource consumption efficiency seems to improve. The self-sufficiency of the individual or families, however, seems to be compromised. One could even say that cities can be more vulnerable to breakdowns in their services and supply chains. So the question of current concern is, how should cities grow to become more self-sufficient? Or will we need to think about self-sufficient neighborhoods within cities, linking cities and hinterlands, or networks of cities? The answer is still out there, but you can be part of the self-sufficient network.